है फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी, वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ सर्क्यूलर क्यू डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड कीप द बेल रिंगिंग। नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द working of a circular queue. Till the previous video we have seen that why to go for a circular queue by explaining the disadvantage of a linear queue, and then I have introduced the circular queue along with the basic features of circular queue. Now by knowing these basic things with respect to circular queue, let's see the working of a circular queue. Now let's see how circular queue works. The first point is circular queue works by the process of circular increment. That's why the name is given circular queue. Now what is circular increment? So the circular increment is nothing but if and when we reach at the end of the queue while performing any either operation, that is insertion or deletion, we should start from the beginning again. So it is called as circular increment. Now that circular increment is also helps to go round and round, and that's why the name is mentioned over here is nothing but a circular queue. So while incrementing the pointers, that is rear or a front pointer, while performing insertion and deletion operation respectively, that we have to move or go round and round, it is nothing but the circular increment of the pointers. And that circular increment is performed by modulo division with the size of the queue. That how this modulo division helps us to go round and round, that I am going to explain in this slide. So how to go round and round? So the first thing is, every time we supposed to check either of the front or rear pointers have reached at the maximum size of a circular queue. If they are at the maximum size of a circular queue, that after that we supposed to set them to value 0 or to index 0. How we can perform that? So for that, for example, the queue size is 10. So if it is the size of the queue is 10, then the value of x, that is nothing but we can say that either of the pointer, that is front or rear, that we have to divide it by 10, and then we have to take care of the remainder because we are using the modulo division method. In modulo division, the result will be in the form of remainder. So if the remainder, whatever will be the remainder, that will be the next location, next index position where we supposed to go. Why we are going to use a modulo division? Because whenever this, for example, for the size of 10 queue, then the remainder will not be never greater than 9. That will belong to the range 0 to 9 only, and that is our requirement to go forward for the indices, that is between exactly from the range 0 to 9, and which is nothing but our requirement. So that's why we are going to use the modulo division method, which gives us a remainder, and that remainder will be between the range 0 to 9 if the size is 10, and which is our exact requirement. Now we'll see the formula which helps us to understand the circular increment for both of the pointers, that is for front and for rear as well. So whenever we are going to perform the deletion operation, we will take care of the front pointer. While performing deletion operation, if my front pointer is at the end of the queue, that is at the maximum size of the queue, then we will use this formula to set to the next position. So the formula is nothing but front equal to front plus 1, that is the next position, and modulo division by maximum size of the queue. And whenever I will perform the next operation, for example, the insertion operation, in this case, we supposed to update the rear pointer, circular increment in a rear pointer. In this case, we have to use the pointer that is rear, and the formula will be rear equal to rear plus 1 modulo max size of the cue. So it helps to increment the rear pointer. Now these formulas helps us to go round and round, or we can say that for the circular increment in a circular cue. Now let's see all these things with the help of example. Here I am explaining you the insert example, and let's start with the example. Now let's consider that my rear is at the position 7, and now let's go forward for the 8 position, and for that the rear will be incremented by 1 and the value will get inserted. Now let's go forward for the next position, and now my rear is at 9th position and I have inserted the value. Now if I want to insert a new value, could I insert? Yes, I can, and for that I have to increment a rear pointer circularly to 0. Now let's see how we are going to do all these things. Now here I am just visualizing the things, and in the next slide I'll explain you it with the help of formula. So just visualize the thing, like now rear pointer is at pointer 0 or value 0 or index 0, and now I have inserted the value. Now can I insert one more element? Yes, I can, because there is a space available in my cue. So let's increment rear pointer by 1, and it will point to the next position, and here I can insert a new element in my cue. So in this way I have inserted two elements by circular increment in a circular cue. Now how the modulo division method helps us to perform the circular increment? Now here you can see that my rear is at position 9, and if I want to insert a new element, I will check whether the next position is nothing but 0th position is available or not, free or not. For that I should have to move to the next position by using the formula. Now let's see the formula. Formula is nothing but current rear. Here this is current rear, that is nothing but 9, which is pointing at 9 or at index position 9. 9 plus 1 is nothing but 10. 10 modulo division 10, what it will result into? It will result into 0, because 10 is divided by 10, the remainder is 0. This 0 is assigned to rear, and here in the other way round we can say that rear is updated to the value 0. It is nothing but the starting of a cue. So here by applying a formula, I have updated rear to the position 0. If it is empty, I can insert a new element, and here you can see that the position is empty and I am inserting a new element. Now whether the same formula will help us to go forward for the next position, that is at the 1 position. Now let's check what happens. So now here my rear is at position 0. Currently my rear is at position 0. So let's apply formula. 0 plus 1 is nothing but 1. 1 modulo 10, what it will result into? 1 modulo 10, the remainder will be 1. And that is nothing but the updated position of my rear pointer. So that's why my rear will move to the next position. And let's check whether at the position 1 the space is available or not. Yes, the space is available, and I can insert a new element at the same position. So I am repeating the things, like while moving round and round, while going round and round, the formula is helpful to calculate the front position or the rear position by using the modulo division method. If we are going to perform the deletion operation, we will increment front circularly, and while performing the insertion operation, we will increment the rear pointer circularly. And both the formulas will help us to go round and round is nothing but our aim to use the memory wisely in the circular cue. So this go round and round and the modular division help us for circular increment. Thank you all dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment and do subscribe my channel Tech Talks. Here I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel along with the next video of this video series is nothing but the operations performed on circular queue. Here also I am providing a playlist for your reference which will be having all videos related to circular queue. Thank you. Happy data structuring. Happy learning.